Hey everybody, it is Wednesday at noon again, so I'm glad that you're with me for the midweek challenge. Now today, here's the challenge I want to give to you, and it's really kind of question at first, but the question is this, what are your confessions? What? I don't want to tell you my confessions. I get it. Now, when you hear the word confess or confessions, we automatically think about the negative. You know, you're in court and I confess to the crime. I did it. I'm ashamed. I acknowledge I did it. But when you think about the Latin root, it just simply means to acknowledge, or one professor put it this way, to come alongside the truth. All that to say is confessions is used in many realms. There's a theological a doctrine that I had to read, or a document I had to read in college, was called the Westminster Confessions of Faith. It could be any point that acknowledges who we are. Now, many of you know that last year I wrote a book. There it is, Confessions, Finding Hope Through One Pastor's Doubt. And I've told people, even though I tend to be the main character in the book, it's really not about me. It's taking my narrative as a vehicle to really get at some of the questions that people ask about God. Can we really trust a good God? And I take it to get it out there into the world to say, yes, you can. And really, my story is just the understory about his story. Now, a couple weeks ago, a friend reminded me of a book that was written a long time ago, about 397. And the guy's name, or the author's name, was Augustine. Many of you know him as Saint Augustine of Hippo. And there is his book. There it is. Yes. Confessions of Saint Augustine. Now, when I look at that book, and a lot of scholars refer to it as the first great autobiography in the Western literature world. And it really was kind of an autobiography, where Augustine has 13 books within it, where he talks about his own story. But again, he uses it to extrapolate a truth, and a lot of truths about his struggles and coming to Christ and what Jesus did through him into the world. And Augustine rose to become a great man of God. He wrote other things. Well, one of the big titles is called The City of God. But that was his confessions. But here's the question again. What are your confessions? Or another way to put it, what is your story? And I want you to think about your story and stop listening to the talking heads out in the world today. What about you? What do you believe? How has God intersected your life? And therefore, what can you bring into the world today? When it comes to evangelism, a lot of times people say, well, Steve, I don't know how to share my faith. And the easiest way is just starting by, what has God done in your life? You don't have to have all of the answers. Maybe you're watching this today and you don't know Jesus yet, but step back and think, who are you? And then begin to unpack from there. Doesn't matter what the world says, what are you going to say? So that's the challenge. In specific, I want to ask you to just look for opportunities this week. Look for opportunities that maybe God brings somebody into your life or poses a question. You may not have all the answers, but you can say this. This is my story. This is what God has done for me. Therefore, maybe God can do something for you as well. So again, there you have it. If this is an encouragement to you, share it with other people. Like it. Obviously, follow the Kingdomology blog. And as always, be strong. And I'll see you again next week.